When you first install AF, there is no database created for you. You're going to have to create one the first time you launch the PySystem Explorer. I should point out, only the first person who runs PySystem Explorer, probably the system manager, only the first person who runs it is going to have to do that. Anybody else who runs this PySystem Explorer against that same Py server is going to see the database the first person creates. So, well, let me just demonstrate. And while we're doing this, I'll also demonstrate how we can, not only how we can build a new database, but how we can load an existing database. So what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to go ahead and delete my existing databases. Now, why might I do this? That's an awful lot of work, right? Well, I want to demonstrate that, you know, rich as this database is, this training sample database is, I've already got a file that defines that for me. So I don't need to worry about deleting it. I could always create it later on. That's actually, you know, obviously one of those do not do this at home types of things, because if you delete an AF database and you don't have a good backup of it, you're going to be in bad shape. But in this case, for training purposes, I create and delete that AF database all the time as I do different tests. So let me go ahead and start up PySystem Explorer. Now, as I said, if this was the very first time that you've installed AF, at that point you would have gotten a prompt that says, there are no databases, do you want to create one? And you'll go ahead and create one. You'll actually get something that looks very similar to this. You choose New Database, and this is the dialog box you're going to get. So I'm going to go ahead and create this new database. My new database is called Training Sample. And this is a test for class, etc. I'll go ahead and say OK. And there's my new database. This training sample database is completely empty at this point. There are no library objects. There are no, there we go, no element templates. And if we go into the elements themselves, the hierarchy themselves, there is no hierarchy. There's nothing here. There are no assets to display at this point.